To MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at synthetic substitution, also known as the remainder theorem. Okay, you can substitute values into a polynomial by simply taking f of 2 in function notation. What that means is for f of for the function, everywhere there's an x, you're going to plug in 2. So you can plug that in and evaluate. Now we can also use synthetic substitution to evaluate polynomials. So let's say we want to evaluate this quartic equation, for 2. So we could plug a 2 in and evaluate, or we can use synthetic division to help us. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the value 2, and we are going to basically synthetically divide. So let's write our coefficients down. Our lead coefficient is 1. We don't have a cubic term, so there's a 0. The quadratic term, lead coefficient is 2. The linear term has a negative 1, and the constant is 5. Now, synthetic division, we're going to bring down the 1, multiply by 2, and then we're going to add the column to 2. Then we're going to multiply by 2, that gives us 4. We're going to add the column to 6. We're going to multiply to 12. We're going to add the column to 11. We're going to multiply the column to 22. And we're going to add the column to 27. So what this tells us is we have a depressed polynomial, which is 1x cubed plus 2x squared plus 6x plus 11, and the remainder is 27. Well, what we want to look at is this remainder. Okay, we really don't care about the polynomial we've created. What this tells us is when we plug in 2 into the function, our output is 27. So how would we write that in function notation? Well, you would say f of 2, so the function evaluated at 2 is equal to 27. And that is how you synthetically substitute. And the remainder theorem tells us that when we evaluate the function for 2, we're going to get an output of 27. So let's just test our theory. Let's take 2 and plug it into the function. So we're going to do f of 2 the long way. So 2 to the 4th plus 2 times 2 squared minus 2 plus 5. Okay, 2 to the 4th, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, plus 4 times 2 is 8, minus 2, plus 5. That's going to give us 24, minus 2, plus 5. That's going to give us 22, plus 5. And look, we got 27, okay? So you can evaluate the function for the value, or you can use synthetic substitution where you just divide the polynomial by the value, by the input, and your remainder is your output. And that is synthetic substitution, also known as the remainder theorem. Hope this video was helpful.